46-year-old Christian Jax was a librarian and freelance journalist living in Stralsund on the Baltic coast. He wrote the books Beschießung meiner Stadt and Hansestadt Stralsund 1990 to 1994, Vier Jahre einer Stadt, and Die Hexe von Hiddensee. In summer 2010, Jax ran for the left-wing party Die Linke for the district parliament of Northern Pomerania. Since the Yugoslav war, he was active in the peace movement. In October 2010, Christian Jax rang the bell at German Chancellor Merkel's house in Hohenwalde, 60 kilometers north of Berlin. The police on duty in a container did not interfere. Because no one opened the door, Jax went into the garden and saw Chancellor Merkel on the phone. He handed her a letter about a peace plan for the Middle East. Then Jax left the property. The police watched him leaving, but did not stop him. A couple of weeks before, he already had tried to give his letter to Chancellor Merkel at her flat in Berlin. He was sent away by the police. The following week, Jax again showed up at Chancellor Merkel's house in Hohenwalde with the intent to discuss the letter. He was arrested, but because he did not commit any punishable offense, he was committed to a mental institution in Angermünde. The media was told he was a stalker. Christian Jax was not guarded at the Nordhaus, so he left. He then was arrested again by special agents of the Landeskriminalamt. Let's hear some of the statements found in the internet on politikforen.net. Lupus Maximus wrote, "Everybody attacking politicians or having a different opinion is declared mentally insane." This happened after the attack on Oscar Lafontaine, Schäuble and so on. All of these attackers ended in a nut house because they are way safer than prisons. And Steffi replied, "You are right, everybody attacking a politician without any exception was committed to a nut house, whereas a knifer only is put to trial for assault with a weapon." Online Zeitung 24 stated, "No one was threatened, no one injured, no one stalked." But anyway, where would we end if everybody may address the politicians as he likes? One might assume that politicians would listen to the problems and hardships of the people, but one is obviously not even allowed to hand a letter to Chancellor Merkel without disappearing in a nut house. Probably Chancellor Merkel should consider to procure a new people. Andreas Klamm-Sabaoth received the following information given by a spokesperson by the political party Die Linke. Christian Jax, as a member of Die Linke, since many years was promoting international peace. He also peacefully promoted understanding between the religions. According to the spokesperson, Christian Jax's peaceful work was influenced by his religious beliefs, for which he publicly is known. District Attorney Lolita Lodenkemper stated in Neuruppin that Christian Jax was not under investigation. It is not known how long Christian Jax will be drugged and forced to undergo psychiatric treatment to cure him from promoting peace. Only 7 months later, Christian Jax was dead. The obituary on his party's homepage states, "Christian Jax died on 26th of May 2011, leaving us in desolation. He was a committed pacifist and a passionate critic of the capitalist economy and the organization of the state. He regarded them as non-democratic and obstructing human rights. He was intelligent, well-informed and patient, open-minded and friendly. He is leaving a void. We would have gladly supported him when he no longer was able to bear life." So this looks very much like another member of the opposition having been suicided. One out of a large number in Germany.